Hey YouTube, I'm Blake. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about my flight simulator setup. I see a lot of videos out there about flight simulators and their setups, but hardly anybody is running one on an Apple. What I have here is an Apple Mac Mini with the M1 chip running X-Plane. I was able to get X-Plane for $59.99, and then I bought the Logitech flight simulator controls, the Yoke, the hand controls with your throttle controls and things like that, and the rudder pedals, all in a bundle from a place called B&H Photo online for $280.55. This is April of 2023. I bought it about, a month ago. So maybe you can find a good deal like that now. This is the best deal I found. It was way cheaper than everybody else. So good luck out there if you're looking for one. What I want to go over today is how I have it set up, how it runs, and just how things work on this. As you can see, I have it hooked up to two 49-inch Samsung screens. I'm probably going to get rid of that top screen because I really don't need it anymore. I bought the extra screen when I was doing a lot of day trading, but you know, the market right now, I don't do that anymore. So I don't really have a need for it. And as you can see, it mostly just shows the top of the airplane cabin anyway. It doesn't really help you a lot. So let's dive into it. So what we have here is the Logitech controls. So you see here's the Yoke, here's your throttle and everything else. And it has some buttons over here that you can set up to do different things. Now on mine, I have this button right here set up to reset the simulation. So say I don't want to do it anymore, a crash or whatever, or something happens, I just push that button and it starts me off right where I started before. This one takes me out of X-Plane. Running on this Apple, sometimes it does freeze if you have your graphics turned up. So I had that button right there set up just in case that happens. These two buttons I set up to be my my flaps. It comes stock. Those flaps are set up for this button right here, but that's too easy. I wanted to make myself reach over here and push the flaps down, flaps up. I usually use it, leave this down as a kind of a touch point so I can touch that so I can find it without looking. Now what we have here, we have the rudder pedals. It all came in a kit. These are Logitech rudder pedals. I put that level back behind it to get it out from the wall just a little bit. And then we have the Yoke. So the Yoke is the Logitech Yoke. It's pretty nice. It's pretty springy. In, out, goes to itself. You can set a timer on it. This right here, you toggle this, it'll move. It moves the screen around. There's a toggle on the back side right here that will move the screen side to side. It's just a little wheel, just a little three-click wheel. I think it works pretty good. Now I have this rigged up to a powered USB. I read online that would be a good idea. So it's in a powered USB and it goes in the bottom of the dock on the bottom of my Mac Mini. Now you can see I have this little hoodus right here, 3D printed little holder. I use it to hold my keyboard, or you can throw your iPad in it for ForeFlight if you want to. So either or, and it's just something I found on the internet, 3D printed it out right there, you know, and it just screwed in with the existing screws. So get back to how this thing works. So right here we have two Samsung 49-inch screens. I can't even get them in the picture. Here we go. They work pretty good. It's a little much for the M1 chip, and it'll pop up a little message over here and tell you that it's not running as good as it can, but it still runs. When I go down to one screen, it's not as bad. We can go in here and look at my settings. So my graphics settings, you can see I have the bottom monitor is set down 10 degrees. And the top monitor is set up 60. I can't really, it's not very easy to scroll through and find. So it's set up 65 degrees. The monitors aren't intertwined. So it doesn't know that this monitor is right up here and it needs to make the graphics, you know, this much off of it. It doesn't know that they're set up like you would with a computer screen. So you have to tweak the offset of the viewing angle to make it right. If you know how to make it to where I don't have to do that and it does it automatically, please tell me. I would love to know. So you go in here and I have these are my graphic settings. Let's run this on another computer. So I'm going to need to bring this texture quality down on these two screens because it's just, it's not going to work very well. So we're going to come over here, bring that down, and then we're going to bring this down. And it should work pretty well like that. It's not going to be the best. If you have a lot of clouds, it's not going to be the best. But it works. I mean, if you already have the Apple, there's no reason to go and spend thousands of dollars on a gaming computer to play this game. So there we go. Now, the reason I bought this is I'm trying to get my pilot's license. I've only flown one plane one time. It was a Grumman Cheetah. So I bought this because it's a lot cheaper to fly this simulator than it is a plane. I can learn a lot of things in it before I get in a plane, so I'm not learning in the air. I think it's very well worth it to spend the money on it, especially since I only have $340 in it. That's an hour and a half of flight time, you know, nowadays. So I don't think it's that bad. I mean, you might think, but I don't. I think it's a pretty good deal. So I've explained most of this. Let's go over some of these controls. So you have some things in X-Plane. You can push Y and it gets rid of the yokes right there, since you already have one down here. So it gets rid of it for you. And then pretty much the only thing I use on here is the shift number keys will change the view. It'll just change the view. And we're sitting here. I live in Wichita Falls, Texas. So this is at the Kickapoo downtown airport, a couple miles away from me. This would be the airport I would be flying out of. So I figured I will train out of this airport. All right, so we have all the views, and then I use the P for the pause. But everything else I have integrated into here. I'm working on a trim wheel, but I don't have it yet. The trim for now is right here, trim up and down. So you have it, it's just, it's not off of the controls. It should be down here, but it's over here. But it still works. And this thing flies pretty good. I think it's well worth it, you know, to get it. Like I said, I've only flown one plane. I'm not a professional pilot. I'm trying to get my private pilot's license. I figured this is a good way to learn and a cheaper way to learn than in the air. So I'll go ahead and set this up and I'll do a takeoff in X-Plane. Okay, so I'm set up to fly here. I have my chair set up. It's just a normal office chair, but I have it where it won't tilt back to try to simulate a real plane, and I have the armrest pulled up. So I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna push P, take it off the pause, and we're ready to go. So I have my rudder pedals, you can see them moving, and we're gonna go ahead and take off. This is a Cessna 172 that we're flying, so we'll go ahead and take off in it. Once we push the brake. So you can see, this says your rendering options are set too high. X-Plane can't run in real time with the current settings. Minimum frame rate hasn't been achieved in over a minute. That's because I have too many screens on this M1 and our settings are too high. So I want to get rid of this top screen because I'm not really using it. So I'm going to go ahead and take it off later. All right, took the brake off. it up to 55. And pull back. And we're flying. You can move the screen up and down with these arrows. You can see a little bit better out of the screen there. You don't really need to see your rudder pedals or anything like that. And it's pretty cool. It's pretty realistic. Well, as far as I know, I've only done it once, but I mean, I'll kick that rudder pedal right, and it'll kick it right. So, turn this, it'll turn. You go up, it goes up. I like it has noises. You can fly off the noises. You can hear that little wheezing. That means you're about to stall out. See? Look, stalled it out. So I've got to try to get it back where it goes. So, it'll teach you how not to get in trouble. Try to teach you your limits, your turning limits, and things like that. That's all I have for this video. If you enjoyed it, hit the thumbs up button. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Thanks for watching.